Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome to our channel Ek Kadam. Myself Smriti. In this video, you are going to learn about the beta oxidation of fat. First of all, we will learn about the oxidation, some points about the oxidation of fatty acids. So the fatty acids undergo oxidative breakdown, obviously to produce energy. The process mainly occurs inside the mitochondria. The degree of utilization of fatty acids as energy source varies greatly and depends upon the factors like kind of tissues, that it is minimal in the nervous tissue, and main energy source in the cardiac and the skeletal muscles, and metabolic status of the body. It also depends upon the metabolic status of the body, as if you are on prolonged fasting, so the main energy production occurs from fats. Now in the next part of the video, you will see a basic reaction of the fat oxidation and some more reactions that occurs in the beta oxidation of fats.
So this is the basic reaction of fat oxidation, in which the fat are hydrolyzed into glycerol and three molecules of fatty acids in the presence of an esterase enzyme, which is called lipase. So here is the flowchart of the reactions. There are total 6 reactions which occur during the beta oxidation of fatty acids, and it was reported by F. Noob. So first step is activation, second is the transportation, and third one is the dehydrogenation, fourth hydration, fifth dehydrogenation again, and then sixth is transacylation. Let's just have the basic idea of the whole process through this flowchart. So first the fatty acid, it's not complete because the image was stretched out. So in the presence of one ATP, the only ATP consumed is here only, no other ATP is consumed in further process. So with the help of the acyl coenzyme synthase, it is also called thiokinase enzyme, the activation of the fatty acid occurs. Then it is further converted into acyl coenzyme A. This is active fatty acid, but this can't pass through the mitochondrial membrane, so we need some transporter to transport it through the membrane, and this transporter is carnitine. The IMM here represents the inner mitochondrial membrane. Then it gets passed through the membrane, and the third process of dehydrogenation takes place in the presence of flavoproteins, and the enzyme acyl coenzyme A dehydrogenase. Due to dehydrogenation, there is unsaturation in the fatty acid, and the fatty acid becomes alpha beta unsaturated fatty acyl coenzyme. So to remove this unsaturation, we give it water, or hydration of this fatty acyl coenzyme occurs. Then hydroxy group is added on the beta carbon, that is why it is all called beta oxidation of fatty acid, because the number or the nature of carbon that is oxidized, it represents that which oxidation is taking place, so it is beta oxidation. If this oxidation was going to take place on the alpha carbon, so it will be the alpha oxidation of the fatty acids. Then further, again dehydrogenation occurs, and the bonds get break down, and this whole substance is called beta keto acyl coenzyme A, or beta oxo acyl coenzyme A, you can say. Then Then the further this product is breakdown into acyl coenzyme A and the acetyl coenzyme A. Acetyl coenzyme A further goes to the citric acid cycle or the Krebs cycle, and the acyl coenzyme A further initiates this process as again as acyl coenzyme A here written. Now we will have a look over them one by one. First process was activation of fatty acid to fatty acyl coenzyme A. It occurs inside the endoplasmic reticulum or outer mitochondrial membrane. Fatty acid in the presence of ATP and the coenzyme A synthase enzyme further converted into fatty acyl coenzyme A, adenosine monophosphate and the inorganic phosphatase plus water. Then transfer of fatty acyl coenzyme A into the mitochondria. So oxidizing machinery is located inside the mitochondrial membrane, mediated by a shuffle system formed of carrier molecule called carnitine palmitoyl transferase. Acyl coenzyme A can't pass through this membrane, inner mitochondrial membrane. So with the help of carnitine, it is converted into the acyl carnitine. With the help of carnitine, it converted into acyl carnitine and the leftover products. This reaction takes place, and then this acyl carnitine, in the presence of the enzyme acyl carnitine transferase, again further divided or separates the carnitine and the acyl coenzyme A. So through this way, the acyl coenzyme A passes through the mitochondrial matrix, and in mitochondrial matrix there is an enzyme acyl coenzyme A synthase, which helps to occur this reaction. Now the fatty acyl coenzyme A is in the mitochondrial matrix, and so dehydrogenation of fatty acyl coenzyme A occurs in presence of flavoproteins. FED acts as proton acceptor in the presence of flavoproteins. So here it produces a trans double bond between second and third carbon, that is alpha beta unsaturated fatty acyl coenzyme A. The FADH2 here passes the electron to the electrotransport chain and produces two ATP molecules. Hydration of unsaturated fatty acyl coenzyme A in the presence of enol coenzyme A hydrase, it produces beta 3 hydroxy acyl coenzyme A. Then comes again dehydrogenation of beta hydroxy acyl coenzyme A in the presence of the dehydrogenase enzyme, so beta keto fatty acid coenzyme A. Then comes the transacylation, the last reaction of the process of the oxidation, and it occurs in the presence of beta oxoacyl transferase or beta keto acyl transferase. This reaction also calls thiolysis or thiolytic season. So here we can see the fatty acyl coenzyme A goes to the next round of the oxidation. And the acetyl coenzyme A enters the Krebs cycle to produce CO2 and water. In the end of the process, let us learn how much amount of ATP are produced by the beta oxidation of fatty acids. So we are taking here stearic acid as an example. It is a carbon 18 molecule. So 18 carbon molecule, and it, according to Lennon, that Lennon proposed that beta oxidation may be represented by a helix in which each turn of the helix of fatty acid is shortened by 2 carbon atom and a departure of 4 hydrogen atom. You can see here they are getting reduced by 2 carbon and 4 hydrogen atoms are removed one by one. So in stearic acid. The stearic acid will undergo eight turns and produces 9 acetyl coenzyme A molecule.
Each turn of the helix of beta oxidation yields 1 FADH2 molecule and 1 NADH plus H positive. 1 FADH H2 molecule comprises 2 ATP and 1 NADH molecule comprises 3 ATP. There are total 8 turns. And from one turn we get 1 NADH2 and 1 FADH2. Total number of ATP from them will be 5 ATP. So 8 turns, this is produced by one turn. So for 8 turns it will be 8 into 5. Plus 9 acetyl coenzyme A molecules are also produced. So 1 acetyl coenzyme A produces 3 NADH, 1 FADH2 plus 1 GTP. 1 NADH is equal to 3 ATP. So 3 NADH comprises of 9 ATP and 1 FADH2 molecule comprises 2 ATP. So 1 FADH2 molecule comprises of 2 ATP and 1 GTP contains 1 ATP. So there are total of 12 ATP production from one molecule of acetyl coenzyme A. Now we have 9 acetyl coenzyme A molecule, so 9 into 12. This comes out 148. But as we know, we have utilized 1 ATP in the initiation of the process, so minus 1, this will be 147. And we are taking 18 molecule compound, that is stearic acid. So per carbon energy production will be 147 by 18, which is lump sum equal to 8 ATP. And if we see the energy production in glucose molecule, then per carbon, then it comes out 38 by 6, which is approximately equal to 6 ATP. So we can see that fat produce more energy than carbohydrates.